Toy Story of Terror was always designed to be a television special. Whatever story we were going to be telling had to be told within the confines of half an hour of network television time, which equals about 21 minutes and 30 seconds of screen time for our story. Actually, it's exactly 21 minutes and 30 seconds. It's not a frame more or less. There is no wiggle room. You have to tell the story in that time. So it was an exciting challenge for us because it meant we had to be very deliberate about what was on screen and what was left on the cutting room floor. So along the way, in order to do that, we had to lose some things that we really like, and that's what you're gonna see in the deleted scenes. We wanted to set up one of the horror movie genre tropes of the main character seeing something that the rest of the group doesn't see, that gives them an indication that things aren't quite right here. And so that's what we wanted with Jesse, and that's what we were hoping to achieve with this Pencil Topper trilogy.
If you could just put your name and address in the registry right here.
Got a pen in here somewhere.
Here you go. We do serve a continental breakfast from 7 to 9 right here in the old office. You like cereal, sweetie?
Help me!
Guys, there's a toy out there. I think he needs our help.
What is it? Let me see.
It's right over there.
What toy? That's just a pencil. What, are you losing your marbles or something?
It was there just a second ago, I swear.
Jesse, you've been through a lot. It's only natural that your state of panic might cause hallucinations.
I didn't hallucinate. There was a little toy right out there that just vanished. Hey, thanks again.
My pleasure. You know, we have a saying around here. At the Sleep Well Motel, you're gonna sleep well.
Next stop, Grandma's house.
Oh, there we go. Hey, Betty, will this work?
Number two? Oh, that's perfect. Hey, thanks, you guys. Thanks for everything.
Don't look at me. It was all Jesse.
So we really liked the pencil topper, Benny. But it posed just a couple of problems story-wise. One of which is, in order to set it up, you have to spend a lot of time with the humans. And we try and tell the Toy Story stories from the toys' point of view as much as possible, because that's who we care about. And also, just a technical issue. I mean, how many things can be in an iguana's throat? It might be pushing the limits of plausibility that there are two hands in Mr. Jones' throat, let alone an entire pencil topper. This scene came out of the experience of going to a hotel, going into the lobby and seeing that kind of display case that's usually off to the side that has all the travel brochures for the roadside attractions that are in the area. And they're always kind of a little odd, you know? You're like, what is that? And intriguing, and if you had time, you'd probably go to one or two of them. So we really liked this idea, but eventually we just had to cut it for time.
I don't care where we are.
as long as I'm not stuck alone in that box.
Hey, guys, check out the travel brochures they got around here. Banjo World, Cheese Museum, Daffy Town.
Oh, a Jurassic Water Park!
If you can just sign in here in the guest book, and I'm going to need to see a major credit card for the incidentals.
Originally, we opened Toy Story of Terror with this scene, Road Trip Roulette. We wanted to start the film back in the world of Toy Story, and we wanted to show Jessie as a strong character and remind everybody about her vivacious personality, her go-get-em attitude, before she falls into the box and has her episode of claustrophobia and her fear of being alone. And so we kind of know what we're moving back towards, because we want her to get back to her regular self. Eventually, we replaced this scene with the horror film opening, which did a lot of stuff for us, setting up Prickle Pants and his narration. It feels more in the world, and we get to use a rubber bat.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, place your bets.
Yee-haw! I need more betting chips. Can I borrow your helmet? I'm good for it.
Why don't you bet your hat?
Good thinking. Feeling good about this one. Let's bet a knuckle band-aid. And throw in an ace bandage as well.
This table's too round.
Let out some more air, silly.
Oh. Much better.
Fellas, all in. Come on, big money.
I'm afraid it's come to this.
All right, everybody. Betting is closed.
This is so fun! Go, 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 go!
Come on, let her rest. Maybe need to do parachutes.
And Potato Head is the winner! Prickle Pants wins.
Oh, what a relief.
Hey, no fair. The ball landed on us.
Woo-hoo! That was so much fun! Let's play that again. Prickle Pants, great game, big win. We could probably get another couple games in before we get to Grandma's. Yee-haw!